Yeah, he's becoming loud and clear here.
The idea is, with the technology that's available these days, with satellite streaming technology and internet too, we're able to wire people in to what the ship is doing in real time. So the advantage to having this Inner Space Center here as the hub for this remote ocean exploration program is that we can wire people in to what the ship is doing. We can connect them with streaming video, we can connect them with streaming audio, so that a participant from shore can take part in what the ships are doing remotely in real time. The two ships that we work mostly with is the Oceanographic Explorer and the Nautilus, and they are both equipped with remotely operated vehicle systems. So these ROV systems have high definition video cameras on them and other sensors that collect various data sets. All that information is streamed up to the ship that's on the surface through a fiber optic cable and tether that connects up to these robots. So in real time on the ship, we receive the video and the data and information from these robots.
The NOAA ship Oceanus Explorer was transferred to NOAA from the US Navy in 2004 with a chunk of cash to refit it. We spent about 4 years refitting the ship for the purpose of ocean exploration. So it has a dedicated remotely operated vehicle platform, as well as the capability to send the information to shore in real time, the telepresence capability.
The Nautilus is one of the primary partners for the Inner Space Center. So it is on a mission for doing an exploration program in the Mediterranean and Black Seas for about 4 months. And they'll do 8 or 9 different legs to working with different countries around the Mediterranean region. So some of their mission is archaeological, like all the work that we're doing in Turkey, both in the Black Sea and in the Aegean. The Graduate School of Oceanography has an excellent program in blue water oceanography. Both missions of these ships are related to exploring the depths of the oceans away from our coasts and work in all oceans of the world. And URI was a natural home for that.
As we know, the funds are dwindling for ocean science, for science overall. So we're looking for more efficient ways to broaden our scope, to increase the pace, and to have more involvement with the general public. To bring the information to shore in real time has really expanded those opportunities immeasurably.
There's exciting research going on here at URI. It's not just about what the ships of exploration are doing. There's people that study tsunamis, people that study hurricanes, people that study global climate change, people that study alternative energy, people that study natural hazards. All these sorts of things are great things to communicate to audiences all over the world, and we can do it right here from the Inner Space Center. So I'm hoping that more partners come to the table, that we can get more students and faculty from the university involved in what we're doing, and then realize a dream of sort of doing more education, not just for Rhode Island, but for other places.